I'm Becky from the Carey Library, and today I'm going to show you how to create a 3D drawn jack-o'-lantern. So to do this, we use 3D drawing pens. A 3D drawing pen is kind of like a glue gun, but it uses plastic, so it heats up the plastic and you can draw with it the way you would draw a pencil, and I'll show you how to do that in this video. So you need the 3D pen at the library. We have them by a company called 7Tech. You also need some filament. Filament is what goes into the pen and gets heated up, so it's like plastic spaghetti, kind of. And we have orange, and you want PLA filament. There's two different types generally. There's PLA or ABS. PLA is a corn-based plastic, and it releases fewer particulates when it gets warm. So that means it smells better and it isn't bad for your lungs the way that ABS filament would be. You're also going to need a stencil. If you checked a 3D pen out from the library, that stencil would come along with it. Or later this month, we will have some 3D drawing classes where we'll make these pumpkins. We'll have them for grades 4 through 12. So check out the library website to see if you can sign up for those. They're in October 2017 3D drawing jack-o'-lantern classes. So we'll get to it and figure out how to make this guy. Okay, so I'm going to start making my pumpkin. This is the stencil I have. I have my 3D pen plugged in. I'm going to start it so it heats up and gets ready to go. And then I'm just going to trace everything I have on this stencil in order to build the basic skeleton for my pumpkin. And then I'll fill in all the extra space to make a solid object. So now I just peel all of the pieces off. With this particular piece, I'll actually need three of them, so I'm gonna have to make two more quick. A little bit of the ink from the stencil gets on there, but that's not a problem. I'm going to start with my base and attach my first piece of my pumpkin to the base. So to do that, you just set them next to each other. Oop, you can see this. And use a little bit of plastic. Okay, so that's the beginning of our pumpkin skeleton. The next thing we want to do is take these three parts. So this smallest one, the smallest one is for the bottom of the pumpkin. Yeah, let's actually flip the pumpkin upside down. Get it on there. And then just put a little bit of plastic at each section. You're gonna take the middle, which is the largest piece, and slide it as best you can into the middle. And now we take the top, and once again, kind of fit it on as best we can. Now we need to attach his face. So just choose where you want the front to be, where you want the face to be. I'm going to go ahead and do it on this part because I have a nice wide section. And I'm just going to put his smile underneath my middle and then put his eyes on top. So there, the eye is attached to the mouth, and then I can also attach him to that top section. The skeleton of your pumpkin. He's beautiful, but he's not done yet. So now we're going to use the pen to kind of wrap filament just all the way around the skeleton to fill everything in. It's going to be the part of the pumpkin that takes the longest, and it's going to use up a lot of filament because while he's little, it's going to take a lot, like 25 feet of plastic to get him looking mighty fine. Oh, also, I have a little tea light candle to light him up. So before I do this, I want to make sure that this fits in. And I should be able to slide my candle easily in and out. So I really filled in quite a bit there, just to help keep that shape before I take my candle out. And now what I'm gonna do is continue to go around here and kind of wrap the plastic so I'm not gonna go like this close the whole time. I wanna kind of quickly wrap it around that base, and that'll really be the quickest way to build up this plastic and fill the space in. Thank you. I'm gonna kind of push this part out. Well, it's still like not like hot, but it's warm. Just so it's a little bit rounder. Cute! We're gonna fill in some of these gaps later, but right now we're just trying to get as much basic pumpkin stuff done as we can. So at this point, everything has orange on it. The problem is that he still has lots of gaps and spaces. And when we put our candle in him, well, it fits and stuff, and you can see it from all the sides. And for you, maybe that's okay. If you want to be done now, then you're done. And you just need to get him a stem and some vines. But I want to fill in some of these gaps a little bit more. So that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so here he is now that I went through and filled in a lot of the gaps. There's still gaps. So if it's important to you personally to have them all completely filled in, you could do that. For me right now, I'm pretty satisfied. Oops. So now I'm gonna work on this stem. Just go ahead and kind of create the stem on top of there. By slowly spiraling some green. So there's my stem. You have to go back on your stencil. There's the twirls that you can use to make vines. You can just twist those. And you can just attach it. So we're done. In total, that took over an hour to complete. It might take you longer or a shorter amount of time depending on how much you want to fill in on your pumpkin. And you could always go back to it later and fill more sections in if you don't want to do it at one time. But yay, pumpkin!